know, in the book of Isaiah, it says that the wicked are like the troubled sea when it cannot rest, whose waters cast up mire and dirt. There's no peace for the wicked, says my God. You know, that's what all of mankind wants, is peace, peace with God. And to contrast that, Jesus Christ himself said in John 16, in me you will have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world. You know, this desire for peace is so strong in people that they'll do almost anything to get it. And you'll fill it with many other substitutes like drugs and sex and alcohol, maybe entertainment, maybe legitimate things, but only Jesus Christ will satisfy that longing. You know, the wisest man ever recorded in history, King Solomon, this is a man that had wealth in abundance. He had everything that we might hope for that would satisfy. And he said in Psalms 127:1, unless the Lord build the house, they labor in vain that build it. Jesus Christ himself said, what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? In the Gospels, Jesus describes two men, a foolish man and a wise man. And the foolish man is like somebody that hears what to do but doesn't do it. And Christ likens it to like a building. You would build a building on the sand, and that's your foundation. And you build on top of that sand. And then what happens is the floods come, and the winds come, and the rains come, and the house crumbles. And it says, and great was the fall. On the other hand, the wise man is likened to a man who builds the same building on a rock. And those same floods come. These are the circumstances in our life, the trials of life. The rain beats, the wind beats, but the house stands firm. So you can see the difference is, what is your life built on? What is your foundation? Just being down here at the beach is a perfect example of God's love. He speaks to us through his creation. As you look at just the vast amounts of sand, in Psalms we're told this, how great are my thoughts towards you, and the sum of them, if they could be numbered, they'd be greater than the sands of all the seashore. And that's just put in a context that us humans can understand, just the love of God. And that's something that every one of us desperately want, is to be loved. And we're loved by the creator of the universe. And he gives us a little demonstration here that it's greater his thoughts towards us than the grains of all the sand on all the beaches in the world. So you may be responding to this truth. You may be somewhat interested, but in your heart you're saying, you know what, I need to clean up my life first before I come to God. Let me just tell you from experience, that'll never happen. God's word says in Isaiah that the very best that we can do on our own is like filthy rags. Jesus Christ is willing to take you just like you are. Once you receive him into your heart, he will transform you, and then he will help you change your life. You can't do it on your own works. So let me share with you the good news. But before I do that, I have to give you the bad news first. And I think you'll track this if you're honest with yourself. Every single person on the face of this earth has sin in their life. We transgress against God. Many people that I talk to say, well, you know, I haven't murdered anyone, I haven't killed anybody. But if you read God's word, we have all sinned. And if you're honest with yourself, at times you might think a thought that you shouldn't. You may say something that you regret. And God's word says if you're guilty of one, you're guilty of all. I have no trouble recognizing this in myself. I blow it every single day. But there's a problem, because I recognize that we all sin and we fall short of the glory of God. But God's word says the wages of sin is death. So I have a problem. But it goes on with the good news. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. So in Romans it says this, for whoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. And that's how you build your life on the foundation. God's word says you're a new creation. You're transformed into a new creation. You're one of God's children. a favorite passage of many is John 3:16. For God so loved the world. Make that personal. If you're watching today and you're connecting with a thought, you want to have peace, you want to have hope, you want to have direction in your life, you want to feel loved. All of this can be found in relationship with Jesus Christ. Does that mean it's going to be easy? Absolutely not. From my experience, life still can be very hard. But to know why you're here, to know what your purpose is, to have the rules to live by, and to know where you're going when you die, that's an awesome reality. So for God so loved the world, you, that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You know, today would be a great day. As the scripture says, today is the day of salvation. And I pray if you're listening to this, that you just give up trying it on your own and call out to Jesus Christ to save you from your sin.